Yo, how's it going guys, Adamx here, hope you're all doing well, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you a really effective way to lower your ping and improve your network speed. Before we get into that though, I just want to apologize for not uploading for almost like 40 days now. I had exams for 2 weeks and then the rest I was learning how to code, and I already made a new program that automates tweaking and does a lot more than my paid optimization service that I offer on Twitter, which already has a lot more tweaks and optimizations than my videos on its own. But yeah, I just wanted to apologize for that guys, and also wanted to say that I have a lot of new optimizations coming out soon for all of you. And lastly, thank you so much for 60k subscribers. And with all that being said guys, let's get into the video. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do will be updating our network drivers. There's a lot of people I've seen that just rely on Windows Update to update their network and GPU drivers automatically. And I don't recommend that at all, since Windows Update doesn't always update to the latest or best driver. I've helped a lot of pro players with their PCs before, and 80% of the time they have a 2015 or a 2018 network driver with horrible settings. And when I updated it, that alone lowered their ping by a decent bit. Same thing goes for GPU drivers, but I'm not going to really focus on that right now. But if you're interested about GPU drivers and how to correctly update them, make sure to check out this video I made recently on how to correctly install GPU drivers. Anyway, with that said, let's first disable automatic driver updates to avoid Windows from giving us a bad driver again after we update the one we currently have. So to do that, you want to click your Windows key and R at the same time and then type in regedit. After that, click enter. And when you're in here, simply just want to double click on HK local machine, and then you want to double click on software, then you want to double click on Microsoft. After that, you want to scroll all the way down till you find Windows, and then you simply just want to double click on it. After that, double click on current version, then you want to scroll down till you find driver searching. After you find it, just click on it once. And on the right, you want to find the Z-word called search order config. If you don't have it, simply just right click anywhere here, click new, and then click Z-word and name it search order config. After that, you simply just want to make sure that it's set to 0 by double clicking on it, and then make sure that the value data right here is 0, and then click OK. After that, you want to go on the right again and then scroll all the way up till you find the software key. Just scroll all the way up, and when you're here, instead of clicking Microsoft, you can just click on the arrow beside it, and then you want to scroll down and double click on policies. After that, double click on Microsoft, then double click Windows. And then you want to click only once on Windows Update. After that, you want to go into the right here, and you want to right click anywhere, click new, and then click Z-word, and you want to name it exclude WU drivers in quality update. After that, you want to set the value to 1, but I already have the value created, so it doesn't allow me to create another one with the same name. Simply, after you create it, you just want to double click on it and make sure that the value data is set to 1. After that, click OK. And also, one last step I prefer to do is disabling it through Control Panel 2. So simply click your Windows key and R at the same time, and then type in System Properties Hardware. After that, click Enter. And in here, you simply just want to click on Device Installation Settings, click No, and then click Save Changes. After that, you can click OK. And you can exit out of registry, and after doing all that, restart your PC, and now you can proceed with following the video steps to get the best network driver for your PC with also the best settings. Alright, so now we're back into Windows and ready to update our network drivers. Before that though, you need to know what is your network adapter's brand. So to find that out, click your Windows key and R at the same time, and then type in devmgmt.msc. After that, click enter. And then in here, you want to click on the arrow beside network adapters to expand it. And then here you will see all the network adapters connected to your PC. Some of you might also see WAN ports, you can just ignore those. So basically, if you use Ethernet and in here you see a Realtek PCIe family controller or a name near to that that just includes Realtek, then you have a Realtek network adapter. Some of you might have other brands such as Intel, Killer Networking, or Broadcom. I will show the steps for each of those four, but if you have a different network adapter, then I would recommend searching up its name and trying to find the manufacturer's website and downloading the compatible drivers from there. But for now, let me first show you the steps for Realtek adapters, Intel adapters, Killer Networking adapters, and Broadcom adapters. Starting off by the Realtek adapters drivers, click on the Realtek link in description and then basically just follow my steps. In here, you want to scroll all the way down and basically click on the download that is compatible with your Windows version. So if you're on Windows 10 like me, just click on the icon beside Win10 Auto Installation Program. And then in here, you can simply just type in any fake email. It won't really matter at all. After that, click download file and simply just solve the CAPTCHA test. Also guys, if you get a math question, please solve it. Don't copy paste it, because I made a video about this before, like almost the same thing, and someone literally just copied the question instead of answering it. So yeah, so after doing that, simply just click go. And when it's done downloading, you can simply just open your downloads folder, which will most likely always be where you downloaded it. And when you're in here, simply just right click on it, then click extract all, and then make sure to check this option right here and then click extract. And after you've done that, you can now simply just double click on this exe right here, and it's gonna start the installation setup, which should be pretty simple and self-explanatory. And now that you updated your network driver successfully, you can go ahead and skip to the part where we optimize your network adapter settings for lower latency and faster network speeds. And now for Intel adapters, you simply want to click on the Intel adapters link in the description, and then basically click download under the compatible download for you. So if you have a 64-bit system, which will be most of you, click download right here, and then click I accept the terms in whatever, and then wait for it to download. If you have a 32-bit system, click download on the other one at the top. But again, most of you will have 64-bit systems anyway. And after it's downloaded, it's basically the same steps as for the Realtek driver. You simply just want to open your downloads folder right here, and then when you're in here, you simply just want to right click on ProWin x64, click extract all, make sure to check the option right here, and then click extract. And after that, you can simply just double click on ProWin x64.exe, wait for it to zip, and when it's done, simply just click next, click I accept the terms, click next. And then something I like to do is only check device drivers. Some of you are going to have like some other options right here. Just make sure to check device drivers and uncheck the rest. I don't have an actual Intel Ethernet adapter, so I can't like show you the steps, but you're simply just gonna uncheck the rest, check device drivers, click next, and it's gonna say copying files, etc. And when it's done, your network driver successfully updated. And now that you updated your network driver successfully, you can go ahead and skip to the part where we optimize your network adapter settings for lower latency and faster network speeds. Now for killer networking drivers, simply just open the killer networking link in the description, and when you're in here, simply just want to click download on this button. And when it's done downloading, you simply just want to run it by double clicking or just clicking on it right here when it's done. And it will walk you through the installation setup, which should be pretty simple to follow and self-explanatory. And now that you updated your network driver successfully, you can go ahead and skip to the part where we optimize your network adapter settings for lower latency and faster network speeds. And then lastly, for Broadcom adapters, just open the Broadcom link in the description and then scroll all the way down right here, check this box, click I agree, and it's gonna immediately start downloading the driver. And when it's done downloading, you simply just wanna double click on it or click on it once to run it, and then simply just follow the installation setup, which should be pretty easy to follow. Now that we have the latest network drivers, we can now start optimizing our network adapter settings for best latency and throughput by disabling any power saving features and tweaking other settings that just slow you down. To do that, simply just click your Windows key and R at the same time, and then type in devmgmc.msc, and then click enter. And then you wanna double click on the network adapter you updated, go into the power management tab, and then here make sure to uncheck allow the computer to turn off this device to save power. After you've done that, you now wanna go to the advanced tab, and then when you're in here, please keep in mind that these settings can differ from PC to other. So just change the ones that you already have from the ones that I'm going to say right now. So first off, if you have the advanced EEE option, make sure it is always disabled. And then do the exact same thing for the energy efficient Ethernet feature. Make it disabled as it's a power saving feature too. The exact same thing again for gigabit light as it's a power saving feature too for people that have gigabit speeds. So make sure that it's disabled. After that, exact same thing for green Ethernet as it's another power saving feature. After that, I wanna scroll all the way down, and then for power saving mode, you know what I'm gonna say, make it disabled. And for Intel adapters, you're gonna have ultra low power mode, you wanna make sure that that is disabled as well. And then you wanna scroll all the way down and make sure that all these wake on features are set to disabled. And for the last one, WOL and shutdown link speed, make sure it is set to not speed down. And that is it for the settings I recommend to everyone. But if you want to play around with some more settings, which I personally do anyway, here are the settings I would recommend you to test. First one I recommend you test would be flow control. Try setting it to disabled and then basically test with it and check your results, see if they're better, see if they're worse, and set it to what was best for you. The other setting I would recommend testing with would be receive buffers and transmit buffers. Having these settings too low can cause packet loss in some cases, and I also noticed that hiring them resulted in better network speeds, so I would honestly just recommend you test them with the maximum value they can go to. Also keep in mind that receive buffers won't always go as high as transmit buffers, and also make sure that if you're going to test with these settings that you know their default value just in case you want to go back. And after you're done in here, you can click OK, and after that you can exit out of Device Manager. So that was it for the video, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it and that it helped you all out. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe, and I'll see you all in the next one.